Should the Browns be the favorites in the AFC North now?
Yes, they should be, and I realize we're talking about this before the draft, and it's a competitive division. I'm talking about right now, Stephen A., right now before the draft, the Browns should be favored. They're a double-digit win team, came up in the World, won games they needed to win late, even when they lost to Baltimore. Stephen A., that was a back-and-forth game. When you look at the Browns, where's the weakness exactly? Baker Mayfield, the former number one overall pick, didn't look great early on in his career because he played for four head coaches in basically two seasons. As soon as he got a head coach that was right for him, he had a very good season last year. And you look around, he has weapons everywhere on offense in terms of guys to throw the ball to, and that's without Odell Beckham Jr. Now, I've been on the record, Stephen A., I think Odell and Baker are best off apart from each other, right? They'll both be more productive. And the Browns are listening to offers for Odell, and maybe they'll get some good stuff for him. God forbid he should simply return to the Browns, and now Odell is out on the field, yet another weapon for Baker if they can figure that out. And I didn't even mention the running game. The running game is dominant behind, you know, with two great backs. Stephen A., the reason for that is not only that the backs are very talented, they have the best offensive line in the business. Pro Football Focus ranked them number one pass blocking and run blocking, right? Number one in the league. You know, the Cowboys' offensive line isn't what it once was. So they have a dominant offensive line, weapons everywhere, a running game. Now look at the defense. They spent free agent money this year. The draft hasn't even happened yet, bolstering that defense. And Jadeveon Clowney, Miles Garrett, he's incredible. Jadeveon Clowney has been an underrated player because he's a good run stopper, right? He doesn't put up sexy stats. The sacks is what we look for. It's easy to understand with defensive end or guys who play on the defensive line. And he can go get the quarterback. We've seen it when healthy. He can go get the quarterback, but he can also stop the run. You have him and Miles Garrett coming off either end with all the additions on defense. Yeah, not only will I say that the Browns should be favored in the AFC North right now, they're contenders to win the Super Bowl. They are Super Bowl contenders.
Well, they're contenders, but I'm not gonna give them the nod as the favorites because they're the Browns. What can't go wrong will go wrong to some degree by Lake Erie. This is what it has been, and this is what it will continue to be. Now, they've obviously improved. You got Baker Mayfield that went up in touchdowns from 22 to 26 from the previous year, but he went down in interceptions from 21 to 8. So Kevin Stefanski deserves a boatload of credit. He did a hell of a job last year as the head coach for the franchise. Him and Barry as the GM, obviously an African-American, very, very proud of what he's doing thus far. They're definitely a contender. I'll give them props and credit for that. I don't know how big of a pickup Clowney is. Remember that Clowney is supposed to be somebody that can register sacks, Max. He's got like three in the last 2 years. Not a single sack last year in the 8 games he played in Tennessee, just 3 the year before he played in Seattle. And let's also be honest about the fact that he's lost out because this guy was looking for about $18 to $20 million a year when he ended up departing from Seattle. And now he's signing 1 year deals worth up to $10 million. Obviously, there's incentives in that contract that's going to get him to $10 million. So somewhere along the way, if the way what you feel about him, evidently a lot of people don't because they ain't willing to pay him to have them on their team, the exorbitant amount of dollars that he was looking for. Him being there with Miles Garrett and Sheldon Richardson, I get it. They're formidable, no doubt about it. But when I look at the rest of the AFC, this is the AFC North that we're talking about here. And I think it's the division that has been historically owned by Pittsburgh or Baltimore, and I think that will continue to be the case. When you've got Lamar Jackson being as electrifying as he is, and you've got faith in an organization that'll probably get him some help. They're Rough Riders, they're experienced, they know what they're doing. I like what I saw from them in the playoffs, even though they lost. They were highly competitive, and I look at it from that perspective, and I say on paper, the Cleveland Browns are definitely contender, and they're real and live, as you would say, Max. And I don't disagree with you, but in the end, I really, really do believe it comes down to Baker Mayfield. And even though he has improved and he did have a good second half of the season, got them to the playoffs, got a playoff victory over my Steelers, Baker Mayfield deserves a whole lot of credit. I get all of that. But I also think that let's not act like he was lights out, like this is a future Hall of Famer in the waiting. Could it end up that way? Sure. But that's not what we've seen as of yet. And I think if you're an opponent and you put it in the hands of, and you force the Browns to put it in the hands of Mayfield to make him beat you, I want to see that to believe that they're the team to beat in the AFC North. I'm not convinced of that. I'm not saying they can't make the playoffs or anything like that. Not saying they can't make any noise. But when we talk about the favorites in the NFC North, I need more of a body of work than what I've seen to elevate the Browns to that status.
Actually, you can look at the division right now. And when you look at the quarterback position, you can't just isolate the quarterback position and say Baker's better than Lamar Jackson, right? But when you look at the production you expect to get from the quarterback position, Ben Roethlisberger has no offensive line, consequently no running game. And as a result, considering his arm's not what it used to be, those disadvantages compound. We saw it last year. I expect to see it again this year. I take Baker over Ben this year. Lamar Jackson, they need a dynamic offensive weapon or two to go with Hollywood Brown, who's not a number one receiver. He's fast, but he's not a number one receiver. And so they don't have that right now. That's why I say, like, I reserve judgment till after the draft. But right now they don't have that. I'd expect Baker to be more productive given his offensive line and running game and pass-catching weapons than Lamar. And now you finally have Joe Burrow, who is going to be, I think, better than Baker. But right now, coming off catastrophic injury as a rookie where he didn't get to play a whole lot because of that injury in his second season, as of this moment, you may be looking at the most productive quarterback passing the ball in the AFC North in Baker Mayfield. Even if he's not an MVP caliber player, he's a pretty good player already and with a chance to get better.
Can't deny it. That's a valid point. Not saying it's not. I'm just saying I don't believe it. You know, there's been plenty of times where we look at stuff and we calculate, where we deduce based on the facts presented to us, this is where we're going to go. But there have been other times when we say we don't give a damn what the facts it would indicate to us. When we're talking about that dude or that franchise or that division or that conference, it ain't happening.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.